Hello everyone. So today we are going to discuss about fundamental units and I am Dr. Surya. So first, units can be classified into three types. So which is your metric system, English system and system international. Again, this metric system can be classified into two types, which is CGS and MKS. Okay, CGS is nothing but centimeter, gram and second. So that is called as the CGS. This is called as your metric system, that is centimeter, gram and second. Similarly, MKS is nothing but meter, kilogram and second. So this is called as your MKS system. So these CGS and MKS system are together called as metric system. Next is your English system, which is nothing but FPS. So FPS is nothing but foot per second. So foot per second is called as FPS. Then system international, so this is again which is called as meter, kilogram and second is called as your system international. So this units are nothing but they are the standards of measurement of physical quantities like length, force, time. So if you have to measure this length, force, time or whatever it is, any physical quantity, if you want to measure it off, then we are in need of some unit. So in order to measure these physical quantities, we are using some standard of measurement, and those standard of measurement is called as your units. So now we'll move upon to our interesting subject called fluid mechanics. So what is a fluid actually? Fluid is nothing but any substance that can be capable of flowing. So which is very easy to flow is called as your fluid. That is called as your fluid. So fluids can be classified into two types. So fluids can be classified as liquids as well as gases. So both are called as fluids. So liquid is nothing but it can flow and it can take the shape of the container, but it will maintain a constant volume. What happens to gases? Gases will expand to fill the available volume. So as in the case of your gas cylinder, so these gases, liquids are incompressible, but gas are compressible. Okay, so we are going to study about the fluid mechanics now. So what is this fluid mechanics? Fluid mechanics is nothing but a branch of science that deals with the behavior of fluids at rest as well as in motion. So that is called as fluid mechanics. So this fluid mechanics can be divided into three types, that is fluid statistics, fluid kinematics and fluid dynamics. So all the things we are going to study about the behavior of fluids, only the behavior about the behavior of fluids we are going to study. So what is this is nothing but study of fluids at rest. So if the fluid is at rest and we are going to study about that, then that is called as your fluid statics. Okay, again I am repeating, if the study of fluids at rest, if the fluid are at rest and we are going to study about that, then that is called as your fluid statics. So next one is fluid kinematics. Fluid kinematics and fluid dynamics, both are the study which we are going to study of study the behavior of the fluids when they are in motion. So when the fluid is moving, so supposing if in a tumbler we are taking a glass and that we are not going to sip anything, just we are going to see it off, then it is called as fluid statics or something like that. The fluid is at rest, it is not moving anywhere, it is standing still. But in fluid kinematics, say if the in the river the water is flowing, so if you are studying anything about the river or then it is called as either it can come under two categories, that is either it can come under fluid kinematics or fluid dynamics. So fluid dynamics is that study of fluids in motion, we are not considering, so without considering any forces that cause the motion. So without considering the force that caused the motion, then that is called as fluid kinematics. Then fluid dynamics is the thing that we are going to consider the force. If the force is considered causing the motion, then that's behavior of fluid, and that study is called as, studying those behavior is called as your fluid dynamics. So fluid mechanics is subdivided into three categories as fluid statics, fluid kinematics and fluid dynamics. Next, we are going to deal about what are those properties of fluids. So we'll see one by one. So first property is called as density or mass density. So the first property is density or mass density. It is denoted by rho, and usually we all have learnt as mass by volume. So density is mass by volume. Here we have to include as mass of fluid divided by volume of fluid. Since because we are learning about the fluid, it is mass by mass of fluid by volume of fluid. So density of water is going to be 1000 kg per meter cube. So this kg per meter cube is called as unit. So then we denote our mass as kilogram and volume as meter cube. So what is the formula for volume, which is length into breadth into height. So everything, this length will denote it as meter, breadth as meter and height as meter. So together it is called as meter cube. So the unit for density or mass density is kilogram per meter cube, and it density of water is going to be remain, we are going to consider it to be as constant. So it is 1000 kg per meter cube, we have to keep in mind. But if you take in case of gases, there will be the variation of density due to the temperature and pressure, there will be variation in it. And the second property we are going to study is specific weight or weight density. Specific weight or weight density, and it is denoted by W. So W is nothing but, that is specific weight is nothing but weight of fluid by volume of fluid. Weight of fluid by volume of fluid. So we have going to consider what is the weight of the fluid, and we are also going to take into account of the volume of fluid. Okay, so weight can be denoted as, what's the formula for weight? Weight is nothing but mass of fluid into acceleration due to gravity. Mass of fluid into acceleration due to gravity. So based upon the acceleration due to gravity, weight, because if you take our weight in the earth will be some around some 70 kg or 60 kg, whatever may be. If you take the same weight in Mars or Venus, the weight will be varying. So based upon the acceleration due to gravity, the weight will be varying. So the weight of fluid is nothing but mass of fluid into acceleration due to gravity. So what we can do is we can keep this as equation number 1 and this is equation number 2. So I am going to substitute equation number 2 in equation number 1. So instead of weight, I am going to substitute mass by volume. So if you see weight of fluid by volume of fluid. So instead of weight, I am substituting as mass of fluid into acceleration due to gravity. So I am substituting, instead of weight of fluid, I am substituting mass of fluid into acceleration due to gravity, and volume of fluid I am writing the same, volume of fluid. So if you consider this thing, already we have learnt that mass of fluid by volume of fluid is nothing but density. So simply I can substitute density here. So mass by volume is nothing but density, this becomes density, into acceleration due to gravity. So what is the symbol for density? We are denoting it as rho. And acceleration due to gravity is g. So the formula for specific weight is rho into g. Okay, the formula for specific weight is equal to rho into g. The specific weight for water, weight of water, that is specific weight of water is not is equal to 9.81 into 1000 into Newton per meter cube. So acceleration due to gravity is 9.81 and this is equal to 1000. So weight into weight of specific weight is equal to 9.81 into 1000. Now we have to get the unit of the specific weight of water. So I'll tell you a simple way of remembering the specific weight of water. So first remember what is the formula. Formula for the specific weight. It is nothing but weight of fluid by volume of fluid. So what do you mean by weight? Weight is nothing but a some force. So the unit for force is Newton. So what is the unit for volume? Volume is, as such I have mentioned earlier, it is meter cube. So meter cube. So the unit for specific weight is nothing but Newton per meter cube. Okay, that's why I have written the specific weight of water is equal to 9.81 into 1000 into Newton per meter cube. Many a times many will get confused with the two terms, saying that mass and for weight they are getting confused with that. So what is the difference between mass and weight? So mass is nothing but it's a property of matter. It is going to remain the same everywhere, but if you take on weight, it depends on the effect of gravity. So based upon the gravity, whether the weight can increase or it can decrease. And another thing you have to keep in mind that mass can never be zero. It will not become zero at all, but weight can become zero. If there is no gravity is acting upon that object, then weight will be zero. As in space, you imagine that you are in space, the weight will be zero, and mass will not change according to the location, but my weight varies according to the location. As I have mentioned earlier that my weight can be 60 kgs in earth, it can be some 120 or 200 in moon. It varies where we are there. And another thing is that mass can be measured using an ordinary balance, but weight can be measured only using the spring balance. So generally weight is measured by means of a unit of force, that is mass into acceleration due to gravity. So we have to take into account of acceleration due to gravity. So weight is measured in terms of unit of force. That's why I have written that weight of fluid is Newton. And mass generally is usually measured in grams or kilograms. So don't get confused with that. So this is the one we have seen, the second property. Now the third property is going to be specific volume. So it is very simple. So specific volume is something like that. So for density we have seen mass by volume. So for specific volume it is going to be ulta, which is something like volume of fluid by mass of fluid. Volume of fluid by mass of fluid. So in simple I can write it as 1 by mass by volume. So I am bringing this term down. So this will become 1 by rho. In simple I can say that it is reciprocal of mass density or density. So specific volume is nothing but a reciprocal of mass density. And what will be the unit for density? It is kg per meter cube, because mass we are going to measure in kg, volume in meter cube. Now it is going to be ulta. So the unit for specific volume will be meter cube per kilogram. So this is the unit for specific volume. So the next property we are going to see is specific gravity. So it can be denoted as GRS. So which is nothing but weight density or density of any fluid or any liquid divided by weight density or density of water. Because we are going to assume the density of water to be same, that is 1000. So it can be written as GRS is equal to rho of any fluid or rho of any liquid divided by rho of water. Since both are density, the unit will get cancelled. So specific gravity does not have any unit at all. So this is the fourth property. And next property what we are going to see is fifth property is viscosity. So what is this viscosity? Viscosity is nothing but it is a measure of fluid resistance to flow. So if you take any honey or something, honey or oil or kerosene, whatever may be, so different kinds of fluids flow will flow more easily than others. Some fluid will be flowing very easily, some fluid will not flow very easily. So based upon that, that is the more viscous the fluid. So if the fluid is more viscous, means there are more layers, they are clinging to each other, and because of that layers are clinging together, it will not flow very freely. Say for example, if you take honey and if you compare, if you are comparing honey with your normal water, so that there will be more layers in honey, and those layers will be attaching towards them, that is they are clinging together with them, and because of that clinging togetherness or attachment with them, they are offering some resistance, it resists its shearing, and the viscosity will be more. So for honey the viscosity is more. So I can say that viscosity is defined as the property of the fluid that is offering some resistance to the movement of one layer of fluid over another adjacent layer of the fluid. So this viscosity of fluid, we can again we can call it as resistance to deformation. Resistance to deformation. So the viscosity is called as resistance to deformation. So it tells about what is the internal friction of fluid, how there is an internal friction inside, how what happens within that fluid. So based upon that, the fluid will be, whether the fluid is flowing very freely or it is not flowing very freely. So this only tells that. So the fluid which is having a large viscosity will be resisting some motion, because it its molecular makeup, as such I have mentioned earlier, it clings together and it will give lot of internal friction. Because of that internal friction, it cannot flow very freely. So the fluid with low velocity, it will be flowing very easily, because its molecular makeup results in a very little bit of internal friction when it is in motion. So this is called as your viscosity. This property is called as your viscosity. Next, the important thing what we are going to see is Newton's law of viscosity. So what is this Newton's law of viscosity tells? It tells that shear stress we will be denoting it as tau. Shear stress on a fluid layer will be directly proportional to the shear strain. Shear strain will be denoting it as du by dy. Okay, so if this shear stress is directly proportional to shear strain, then that is called as your Newton's law of viscosity. In order to remove this proportionality constant, what we'll be putting? We'll be putting an equal to sign, and we'll be putting some constant. So that constant is called as mu into du by dy. So this mu is called as coefficient of dynamic viscosity. In simple, I can tell that mu will be the dynamic viscosity. So viscosity will be classified into two types, as dynamic viscosity and kinematic viscosity. We'll see one by one. So mu is called as your dynamic viscosity. Okay, so what is this mu? So I am rearranging the sentence. So rearranging is something like that. So I can simply take that. If you take, go back to the slide. So tau is equal to mu into du by dy. So this is my equation. I'm just rearranging it as I'm bringing back the mu here. So mu is equal to tau into dy by du. I'm just rearranging. I'm not doing anything. I'm just rearranging this sentence, rearranging the equation. So what is this mu? Mu is my dynamic viscosity. And what is this tau? Tau is nothing but my shear stress. And this equation can be again rearranged as tau by du by dy. So we can write in this way also. So my tau is going to be my mu is going to be my, sorry, this will be my dynamic viscosity, and tau is going to be my shear stress. So what is this du by dy? So this is nothing but my shear strain. Okay, so what is stress actually? Stress is nothing but a force by area. So in simple I can write that mu will be equal to shear stress by shear strain. Okay, so what is the shear stress? It is nothing but force by area is my shear stress. What is shear strain? Which is nothing but change of velocity by change of distance. So this is called as my shear strain. In order to understand the shear strain but better, so I'll just give you an example. So you will be having the confusion, what is this du by dy and all those things. So to understand better, I am giving you an example. So consider this as a table. This is going to be my table. So in a table, I am having a wet cloth, sorry, wet towel, something like that. So if I am having a, wet towel, sorry. I'm having a wet towel in a tablecloth. What I'm doing is I'm suddenly pulling that wet towel. So I'm giving a sudden pull. This sudden pull is called as my du. That is the change in velocity. So certain thing is there. Slowly, if you are not removing it, suddenly you are removing it. So that change in velocity is called as du. And what is this change in distance? So this is going to be the change in distance. So change of velocity by change of distance, it is called as your shear strain. Initially there will be one velocity, now there is a change in velocity, and also there is a change in distance from one side, one place to another side. So this is called as my change of distance. Okay, so now coming back to the thing. So we are going to derive the unit for dynamic viscosity. So mu is going to be shear stress by shear strain. So instead of shear stress, I am putting force by area. And instead of shear strain, I am writing change of velocity by change of distance. So what is this force by area? So force, I will be keeping it as such. And what is this area? Area, how we are denoting it as meter square. Or in simple, I can say that length into breadth or side. If you take a square, it will be side into side or something like that. So in simple, I can write it as length square, some length into some square, that will be my area. And if you take change in velocity, so what is velocity? Velocity is nothing but it is distance by time. So if you are traveling in a bike, so if you want to calculate your speed or something like that, how much distance you have traveled with some respect time, we will be denoting it as kilometer per second or kilometer per hour, will be telling like that. So distance by time is known as the velocity. So instead of distance, I will be writing it as chain length by some time is called as thing. And distance as such, we can keep it as length. So 1 by length. since because it is even in denominator, I am writing the distance also in denominator. So this length and this length will get cancelled. So it will become force by length square divided by 1 by time. So this is how I am getting. So I am rearranging it. So time can go up and length square can come down. So mu is equal to force into time divided by length square. So the unit for force is Newton and the unit for time is second and unit for length is meters. Here you are having square, so meter square. So now the unit for dynamic viscosity, unit for dynamic viscosity mu will be going to be Newton second per meter square. And you have to keep in mind that important thing, 1 Newton per meter square is equal to 10 poise. Suppose if they are giving the unit in poise, you have to keep this conversion in mind. 1 Newton per meter square is equal to 10 points. If the velocity is, sorry, viscosity is given in poise, it should be divided by 10 to get the numerical value in SI units. So Newton second per meter square is in SI unit. So in order to get that in SI units, and if supposing if it is given in poise, you have to divide it by 10 and you have to get it in Newton second per meter square. And similarly, 1 centipoise is equal to 1 by 100 poise. So this should be also kept in mind. So 1 centipoise is equal to 1 by 100 poise. So viscosity of water at 20 degree Celsius, viscosity of water at 20 degree Celsius will be equal to 0.01 poise. So these three things you should keep in mind. So another one viscosity what I have told is kinematic viscosity. Kinematic viscosity. So this is denoted by the symbol mu. Okay. So this nu, so it is nothing but the ratio between dynamic viscosity and density of fluid. So it is the ratio between dynamic viscosity and density. So dynamic viscosity will be denoting it as mu and density as rho. So the in simple, mu is equal to mu by rho. Mu is equal to mu by rho. So what will be its unit? So you know, we already know the for dynamic viscosity, the unit will be Newton second per meter square. So this is the unit. Okay, what we are going to do is, before that we should keep in mind that 1 Newton will be equal to 1 kg meter per second square. So this is the point you have to keep in mind. So 1 Newton is equal to 1 kg meter per second square. So this thing you have to keep in mind. So what I am going to do is, I am just going to substitute, instead of Newton, I am going to substitute kg per meter square. So this will be equal to, so I am just, first what I am going to do is, this is mu by rho. So in first I am taking mu alone. The unit for mu is equal to Newton second per meter square. So instead of Newton, I am just substituting kg meter per second square. Okay, so instead of Newton, I am substituting kg meter per second square into second divided by meter square. Now this second and here 1 second will get cancelled, this meter and here 1 meter will get cancelled. So for mu, I will be getting the unit as kg by meter into second. So this is what I have got for mu. Okay, now for rho, we know the unit is going to be kg per meter cube. So nu is equal to mu by rho. So what I have got for unit for mu, which is nothing but kg by meter into second. So what I have got for density, kg by meter cube. So kg by meter cube. So this kg and this kg will get cancelled. Here 1 meter and here 1 meter will get cancelled. So the unit for mu is going to be meter square per second. So the unit for kinematic viscosity is going to be meter square per second. And as we have mentioned for dynamic viscosity, it is also measured in poise. Here this kinematic viscosity will be also measured in terms of stroke. Okay, one stroke will be equal to one centimeter square per second, but generally we don't use centimeter, we have to use in terms of meter. So instead of centimeter, I have to convert it into meter. So 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So I am using that relationship and I am getting, so this becomes 1 by 100 meter square per second. So I think you get my point. So I am having 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So I am converting the centimeter into meter. So this becomes 1 by 100. So 1 by 100 meter is equal to 1 centimeter. I am using this, and instead of centimeter, I am substituting 1 by 100. And here square is there. I am putting the square. I am converting the centimeter into meter. So I am putting meter by second. So one stroke will be equal to 10 power minus 4 meter square per second. So here it will become 1 by 100 into 1 by 100, since because this square is there. So this is 10 power 4. 1 by 10 power 4 you will be getting. So when it is going to the numerator, it becomes 10 power minus 4. So one stroke will be equal to 10 power minus 4 meter square per second. So in the next class, we'll be learning how to solve the problem, and after the in the forthcoming classes, we'll be learning about the other fluid properties. Thank you. Happy learning.